expression from your room. She got, a smile out there. But other than that, it was pretty much fantastic, Miss Finessi. Ralph, can we rehearse it again?
No time, Mr. Grimm, no time.
All right, company notes.
Baptista.
You should have shaken off Gregory to that entrance to that first scene, understood?
Please, senor. Can I go to the
tent? Bianca. Bianca. Lois.
Yes, Freddy. I mean, Mr. Grimm.
I realize Lois did a nightclub work. You don't have to cheat.
Ah, don't you, though?
You don't have to cheat front, Miss Lane. From your onstage playing scenes with other characters, you do. This is your first show. I know it's hard.
Excuse me. Do you have notes for me, or can I go?
In a moment, Miss Finessi.
Because when you're finished giving acting lessons...
I saw you last film, Miss Finessi, and you could have used it here. In a minute, Harry. All right, talk to you through the bows.
I have a question about my character.
With psychiatric help, you'll be fine. First of all principles. Now leave room for me. Harry, should play some Romeo. That's better. It looks as if somebody's missing. Lucentio! Where the hell is Lucentio?
Bill Calhoun! Bill Calhoun!
Bill Calhoun!
He was here!
Give a Broadway group for a chance to play Shakespeare, and what happens?
His back's killing him. I think he went to the Cairo Buddhist.
Care to join us in your solo bow, Miss Finessi? Music and lights, Miss Finessi's bow. Everybody back to oblivion. Called a star bump.
I believe a star bump. Because we've got this lady in the park.
Harry, run along your dentist. Third call, Ralph, myself and Miss Finessi.
Third call.
Notice a smile in your contract, Miss Finessi.
You bastard!
Ralph, call everybody on. I want to thank almost everyone of you, the fine spirit who showed all throughout rehearsals. Now, there'll be a gang down here from New York with a lot of money, but don't let that worry you. I know we're going to make a hell of a show out of Shrew. After all, we owe it to Mr. Shakespeare. Not to mention those six other guys who've been sitting upstairs rewriting it.
Natural. But I'll never forgive you if anything happens to Mr. Grant, for I'm a star.
Gee, honey, I'm sorry.
If only you meant it.
dice on me, baby. And on stage and for the entire company?
I didn't say it, I just indicated it. What?
5 minutes.
Oh, thank you, Ralph. I just hate.
You know Baltimore. 5 minutes.
How's the house?
You know Baltimore.
There'll be deer running around the balcony. Next time I open a show here, I'll bring my shotgun. At least we'll eat.
5 minutes.
Oh, so much for a Hollywood name. Your fans must have heard you appearing in person. Go ahead, answer the phone. It's probably some secret admirer of yours.
Hello? Hello, darling! Oh, I thought you'd be here by now. What? Oh, you're still at the White House? He is. He's taking your advice. Oh, well, of course, who wouldn't? What? The president wants to talk to me? To unimportant little me? But what I'll say.
Is it true you declared Baltimore a disaster area?
Dare you. I apologize, Mr. President. Can you come to Baltimore to see my performance? Oh, security?
Oh, you'll be perfectly safe. Miss Vanessa keeps the theater empty.
Who was that? That was no one, Mr. President. Just an actor, not a real man like you. Like him. He is wonderful, isn't he? Oh, hello, dearest. The president is telling me how wonderful you are. I miss you so much. I know you have no time to see my little performance in my little show. But when will I see you again? You have the news? It's top secret? Oh, I can't wait! Oh, yes, darling. Oh, darling. Yes, darling. Oh, darling. Yes, darling. Oh, lovely. Two kisses. Mwah. Mwah. I adore you.
I adore you. Will you sing, God? Get those roses out of here. You know I'm allergic to roses.
Patty, take these roses to
Miss
Lane's dressing
room. Oh, I see it. I see it. Is it real?
Oh, it's real.
Is that the Hope Diamond? The one with the curse?
It was his mother's engagement ring, and now it's mine.
His mother must have worn out her big toe. And who is he? The Aga Khan?
No, but he is a jewel. Dear sweet man, he's very big.
Fat?
Historically big.
George Washington?
Does the phrase Second World War mean anything to you?
You're dating Adolf Hitler. Imagine it in heaven.
Fred, you know what day this is? Our anniversary. And you forgot.
What anniversary?
The anniversary of our divorce.
If you must know, I was thinking of sending you a cactus, but no money. I know you're rolling in money.
Every night before I go to bed, that's exactly what I do. Just a roll in my money. Roll, roll.
Hollywood, swimming pool, avocado ranches. Well, I put every penny I could scrape, borrow, or steal into my Cyrano, my magnum opus. I'm sorry you missed it. That was a huge success.
And you closed on Saturday for glorious performances.
I'll have you know there's a general strike.
Oh, you couldn't have been that bad.
Who's this little fella?
That's you at the age of two. Bottoms up.
He's cute. Mind if I keep him?
Oh, you can have this too. And you can drop it.
What's this, a cork?
Yes, our first bottle of champagne.
Our wedding breakfast?
Yes, in my apartment.
You mean that room of yours over the Armenian bakery?
No, you're 5 months complaining. You didn't even have a room.
Well, I think I'd marry you.
It was the first season we closed in the Barter Theater, and they gave you a ham.
You lived off that ham all winter. You forget.
You forget that I got a job in tea leaves and gypsy tea room opposite the GC.
And you forget I demonstrated shaving cream at Woolworths.
That's right. Now I remember my honeymoon at the Woolworths watching you shave.
We weren't married then, were we?
Oh, yes, dear, we were. Mother was coming to stay with us right after we closed on a little British makeshift of an operetta that, for some reason, was a lady in Switzerland, but the costumes were Dutch.
Yeah, so were those salaries. I could have sworn it was right after that new flop revival, the Prince of Potsdam. Yes, I was understudying the lead. I was the youngest understudying the business.
Mm, no, dear, you're walking for us.
Oh.
There was a waltz in it, remember? Something about
Jonathan, you look ravishing tonight. You have made me the happiest of men.
Oh, Your Highness! Oh, that was such a horrible shot.
But you were wonderful. You really were.
We were both wonderful.
We toured all across Europe that summer.
Yes. A week in Berlin, a week in Paris, 2 weeks in Rome.
We fell in love.
Anyone can fall in love when we were younger than Europe.
Still, we fell in love.
It was a good time, Fred. Sometimes I wonder what if...
5 minutes! You too.
Thank you, Ralph.
Whose fault was it?
There's any attacker.
Could have been your ego.
Whatever it was, it's gonna be wonderful tonight. Break the leg.
Mad.
Hello.
What are you doing backstage?
My looking fella. Clean cut. What a figure. What a profile.
Gentlemen, I'm very touched by your admiration and devotion, but I see my benediction.
Very elocutionary.
And note how he does not spit when he falls.
I fella.
As I was saying, gentlemen, this is all very flattering, but I see my fans after the show, not before.
Oh, what grace.
If I had to do something to him, I would cry like a pig.
Remember that professor who played the ponies? You weren't yourself for a week yet. You dumped him in the Potomac.
Gentlemen, I'll be happy to even present you with my autograph just after the show.
No, we got your autograph, and that's why we're here.
What?
A little matter of I-O-U. Ah, here it is. 10 G's. Mr. Hogan. That's my employer. Regards this as a debt of honor.
Mr. Hogan?
As a matter, Mr. Graham.
You're mad. As a matter.
Paul!
All right. Let me see. This isn't even my signature.
That's what they all said. I'm surprised you, Mr. Grant. You signed it all this afternoon after quite a little game at the hotel. We wasn't there, but Mr. Hogan says he's lied you plenty. Good liquor, too.
I've been in this theater since 8 o'clock this morning.
He forgot.
That's human nature for you.
The minute a man signs an IOU, everything goes dark.
The doctors call it magnesia.
We cure it.
I would cry like a baby. Remember that last high-tide fella? I used 3 handkerchiefs.
I don't like my face, do you?
No.
Jeff, would you mind leaving?
Oh, ain't he Nero? We now wish to express all best wishes for a magnificent opening your brilliant talents deserve. I copied that out of Western Union.
Heartiest felicitations. I made that one up myself.
Mr. Grant, during the show tonight, remember, we'll be in the front box, so try and jostle your memory.
We'll be back.
Mr. Grant, I need to talk to you. Let me start off by saying that I really appreciate what you've done for me and Lois here at the theater, but look, Lois is a girl. She's my girl, and I'm a man, her man. And as her man, I would like to tell you that I want you to have a good show for your lady.
Or we'll do it for you.
Hi, Paula.
Hi, Hattie.
So what do you think?
What do I think?
Baltimore, 1947, Shakespeare. Miss Lily Vanessi making her final return to the theater after 8 straight box office bombs. I will tell you, her films bombed more than the Japanese at Pearl Harbor. They went down faster than the Titanic. So what do I think? I think she's standing right behind me. Miss Vanessi, these are for you. Would you be great? Break the leg. I think they're for Mr. Fred. Snowdrops, pansies, and rosemary. Daddy, if you're ready, you can. You didn't forget it.
Of course not. I'll get it.
Time that no one should be admitted to my dressing room without a psychoanalyst certificate. Of course, they may have been overwhelmed to be admitted.
Oh, I'm sure that's it, sir. Everyone feels the magnetism of your personality, sir, on stage and off.
You know something, Paula? You're not only the finest dresser I ever had. You're a true connoisseur of the theater.
Thank you, sir.
Did you deliver my flowers?
Oh, yes, sir.
Did you like them?
Oh, yes, sir.
Excellent. You put a note in?
Yes, sir.
You delivered them to Miss Lane personally, of course.
Miss Lane?
Yeah.
I thought the flowers were for Miss Vanessi, sir.
Miss Vanessi, you idiot!
I'm sorry, sir. I just saw the two of you fighting on stage like the good old days, and you know, whenever I hear you speaking in that goofy German accent, I know you're in love. I mean, I just thought it was Miss... I'm doing it again, aren't I?
Moron! You didn't think how it would you?
On stage, break a leg!
All right, come on, let's go.
My hands are freezing.
Don't be sick, please don't be sick.
Do you think they'll like me? After all, I have been with
them. They'll love me.
Where's that car?
What car?
That's what I mean.
No, it's
here gone. Here it is. Oh, Cliff, just a second, look. Break a leg, darling.
Oh, no.
No, we will not allow
our youngest daughter, to be married until we have been, until we have wed, until we have wed our oldest daughter, Catherine.
To Carter, rather. She's too rough for me.
Surely, if you were Gremio, or you, if either of you can find a husband for Catherine.
A husband? A devil?
Indeed!
Think it out, sir. Though he be rich, and a man be a fool to marry such a shrew.
A man be taking his life in his own hands to marry such a woman.
So, father, it is you who will make this sale to me to one of these maids?
Oh, if only we could find a husband for Catherine, then we would be rid of her. Ah, me.
Her voice.
eyes as clear as newly washed roses. You do, sweet Bianca.
Are you a student to the maid you talk of?
And if I be, sir, is it of any offense?
Though that one word, we will take you hence.
When we're through with you, Bianca won't even recognize you.
Petruchio!
Hello, my brother. How are you?
Good.
What happy wind blows you to Parma from old Verona?
Such wind that scatters young men throughout the world to seek their fortunes. And you?
I came to meet girls.
Me too. Just tell me her father's name.
Her father is Baptista Manola. Her name is Catherine. She's eldest sister.
Fair Bianca.
She likes throwing stools and other household wares. But she lives right over there.
Methinks I hear her now.
That is she, an irksome, brawling scold.
What are you trying to say?
She's a shrew.
Think that little din can daunt mine ears? Have I not my time heard the lion's roar? Have I not felt the cannons in the field of battle? Not to mention the thunders heaven from the skies. And you expect me to believe the theory of some woman is as terrible as these? In a word, yes.
Then you will woo this wildcat?
Will I live?
We promise we'll be contributors as you woo her.
Done. Go tell this bad Baptista Manoa you have a husband for her daughter Catherine. Catherine the curse. A name made for all titles the worst.
Sister, consent to my consent! No pricing! Catherine, just let your sister alone.
She needs your treasure, and she must have a husband, and I must stand barefoot on her wedding day. And for your love to her, you force me into the arms of whatever ape steps at our door.
No, never was a father as grieved as yours.
A word with you, kind sir.
Whisper louder. That is good news, Lucentio. Come inside and we shall discuss this further.
Lucentio.
Thou meek hot wretch!
ladies.
You must answer to what would we do without them? Still, I hate
showbiz. You've been King Kong and gave him rabies.
Cuddling up to that coke canary.
You're jealous.
setting my wedding bouquet down on trash.
That's no excuse for amity, none.
When my lovely mother showed you Bianca and there being a star in the heavens, thou jerk!
Look, Willie, it's not all that. All right, I said to kick some flowers. I even put a note in. But may I remind you, Miss Finessi, that I'm male, free, and 31.
31? Ha!
All right, 32. But the original years. Show me an actor who's done all I've done. My peer did in London.
You never got to London.
My Hamlet in Dublin.
And you got paid in potato mash.
That's all you ever think of, Miss Finessi. Money. You have no soul. I couldn't teach you manners as a wife, but by God, I'll teach you manners as an actress.
Oh, not in this production, my pet.
What did you say?
You heard me. Here's something to remember me by.
What are you trying to do? Kill me, Ruth! I think she broke my rib, Ralph. I really did. Oh, no. How do you tell me the broken rib?
An x-ray?
Where am I going to get an x-ray?
All I got
is that monstrous female. I'm bleeding heavily, Ralph.
I don't see anything.
Well, what do you call that?
Max factor number two.
Oh. I thought it was blood. Skin's bruised, though, isn't it?
I don't see anything.
Did it discolor?
I don't see anything.
That's all I need, a blind stage manager. I would have, if only the show could run.
Oh, it'll run. It's entertaining, vivacious, and calculating to please the discriminating theater goers. You can quote me.
That's not it. It's my co-star, Miss Finessi's quit.
Quitting?
As of now, temperament. Didn't like when we played our little scene.
No.
Oh. She's dressing to leave the theater right now.
She can't do that.
That is, if you gentlemen could talk to her. You know, heart to heart.
Heart to heart.
That's our specialty.
Lily, oh, Lily!
No use trying to persuade me.
Some ardent admirers of yours. Come in, gentlemen.
Are you management?
Miss Vanessa, you have been my idol for years. I married my wife because in a certain light, when it's kind of dark, she might pass for your sister.
How sweet.
Your glorious voice has been an inspiration to me in my work.
What a trooper.
What a personality.
Now, Miss Vanessi, is it true you're contemplating quitting this high-type entertainment?
I am.
Now, Miss Vanessi, you do know the show must go on. I'm just transferring the weight off of one side to the other. You see, Mr. Vanessi, we got a financial interest in the success of this show, as well as personally. And Ms. Vanessi, you gotta play the show out tonight. And at least to the end of the week, Mr. Graham can pay back his debt of honor.
Are you threatening me?
Now, Ms. Vanessi, duet is such an ugly word.
Fred?
This is an outrage! My goods, my chattels, my horse, my ox, my ass, my anything.
Touch